हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू आवर प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्रामिंग इन 8085 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ टू 8-बिट नंबर्स यूजिंग शिफ्ट एंड ऐड प्रोसेस। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मल्टीप्लिकेशन यूजिंग रिपीटेटिव एडिशन। इफ़ यू डोंट नो अबाउट दैट देन प्लीज वॉच आउट दैट वीडियो एंड यू कैन गेट द लिंक फ्रॉम द आई बटन। सो दैट मल्टीप्लिकेशन वॉज बी डन by repetitive addition, but here we will do the multiplication using shift and add process. So let's try to understand this method by taking an example. Let's say we need to multiply 05 hex with 03 hex. Okay, so we will first write it in binary. So I have written them in 8-bit representation in binary. Now we need to multiply them. So this method of multiplication is exactly the same that we use in general multiplication. So first, all of these numbers are multiplied from this bit, right? Then all these number is multiplied from this bit and so on, all right? So as binary has only two digits, 0 and 1, that means when it is 1, we will write this data, but when this is 0, then we will write 0 in place of these data, right? So when we multiply this whole data from 1, we will get this. Now when we multiply this whole data from this bit, we will get this data only. So I'll write 10100000. Okay, so you can see this data is the left shifted form of this data. Okay, see here 00000101 00000101. All right, now when this data will be multiplied by this zero, then what we will get? We will get all the zeros, right? So this is a bit boring, but I am doing it so that you can understand this process very easily. Now when we multiply using this bit, so we will again get zero as the bit is zero, right? So this will be the number. Now we will multiply with this one. So again, we will get all the zeros. And now we will multiply using this bit. So all these bits are zero. Okay, so I am writing all the zeros here. Now this bit. So again, all the zeros. And here the last bit. So again, all the zeros will be written. So as the bits are of 8 bit, we have performed the addition. That means how many steps are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 bits are here. So 8 number of operations are being performed. And how this worked? If this bit is 1, then we will write this whole bit, right? As we have done in case of this and this. You can see the whole bit is being written, but we have shifted it towards left once. And when we encountered a multiplication with zeros, we have written zeros by shifting it two. So in this way, we will perform the multiplication. Now, if we add them, what we'll get? Here one, one, and one, and all the zeros. So I guess I have written all the zeros. This is 4 bit, this is 4 bit, this is 4, and this is 4. Yeah. So this is our result. So we can say the result is 0F hex. And we know 5 into 3 is equals to 15, but in hexadecimal, 15 is equals to 0F hex. Now let's write its assembly language program. So I'll write the program and then we will understand step by step how this will work. So in the beginning, we will input the first data, that is 05 here, and we are moving it into the register E. So register E contains 05 hex. Then we will take the second input, that is from C051 hex, and we are moving the second data, that is 03 hex, into the accumulator. So accumulator contains 03 hex. Okay, now we are initializing the D register with 00, then H register, that is HL register pair, is also initialized with 00. Okay, and the B register is initialized with 08. So you will come to understand about D and HL pair initialization later. But why B is initialized with 08? Because here see, as there are 8 bits, so we have performed these operation 8 times. That's why we have kept a counter in the B register as 08 hex. So this was our initialization part. Now we will go to the loop part. So here the instruction is dad h. So this is used to perform double addition. That means this is used to perform addition between the register pairs. Here as the operand is h, so HL register pair will be added with itself and the result will be stored in HL register pair only. So as HL register pair here contains 00 hex, so upon addition with itself we will get 00. The next instruction is RAL, that means rotate accumulator left. So accumulator contains 03 hex. I have written it into the binary format, so we need to shift it towards left by once. So now the accumulator will contain what? This 0 will come here, this 0 here, then 0 0 0 1 1, and this 0 will go to that side. That means this. Now there is a JNS instruction, that is jump if no carry is generated. So upon shifting, is there any carry generation? No. Here we have got a 0, not a 1. So there is no carry. So we will jump to the location where this skip is written. So this is written here. So we will decrement the value of B. So B will be from 08, it will be 07. And then JNZ instruction, that means jump if no 0 occurs. So here B is not equals to 0. So we will jump from this statement to this location. Okay, then again dad h, that means HL register pair will be added with itself, but HL register pair contains 00. So upon addition we will get the same result, that is 00 hex. Now again rotate accumulator left. So the accumulator contains this data. Now it should be rotated towards left by once. So what we will get? See, 00001100. Okay, I have rotated this content towards left by one bit. Now again there is no carry generation. We have not got any carry. So we will jump to this location and decrement the value of B. So B will be now 06. Then is B equals to 0? That means is 6 equals to 0? No. So on execution of this instruction, the control will go to this location. And again dad h, so we will get the same result, and rotate accumulator left. So what we will get next? 00011000. Okay, so now is there any carry generation? No. So we will go to this location and decrement the value of B. So we will get 05 hex, and 05 is not equals to 0. So we will go to this location and again continue the loop execution. Then again dad h will give the same result and rotate accumulator towards left. So we will rotate it and get 00110000. All right, now is the carry generation? No, a carry is not generated. So again the same statement and decrement the B to 1. So it will be 04 hex. So is 4 equals to 0? No. So again we will go to the same statement and dad h. So we will get the same result, 00 in HL register pair, and rotate accumulator left. So what will be the next content after rotating this? We will get 01100000. If you are having any problem in understanding how I am rotating these contents, you can see my videos on logical instruction in 8085, and you can easily get that video in my channel. So after rotating, we are again checking, is there any carry generation? No. So we will decrement the value of the register B. So it will be 03 hex. Now is 3 equals to 0? No. So again the same instruction, and dad h will give us 00 hex only. Then again rotate accumulator towards left. So we will get 11000000. And till now there is no carry generation. So again B will be decremented to 1. So B was 3, now it will be 02 hex. Alright, we will go to this location and dad h. So again, we will get 0, 0 hex only and rotate accumulator towards left. Now, if we rotate this data, then what we'll get? 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and this one will be shifted to this location. And here, there is a carry generation. As this one is going to be shifted, a carry will be generated. So now, on execution of JNC, we will not jump to this location and we will perform DAD D. Now, what it will do? It means DE register pair will be added with HL register pair. Okay, so what is the DE register pair? D is 00 and E contains what? 05 hex. Okay, so this is DE register pair. HL is 00, right? So 00. Now we will add them as the instruction suggests, DAD D. So we will get 5. So this is the content of HL register pair now. Then after this execution, we will decrement the value of B. So it will be 01 hex now. And this is not equal to 0. So we will again here perform DAD H. That means HL register pair will be added with itself. So this is the HL register pair. It will be added with itself. So what we will get? 000 and this is 10. But in hexadecimal, this is A. Alright. Now after execution of DAD H, RAL. So we will rotate this again. So this 0 will come here and this 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay, this will be the result. And here also this one is going to be shifted towards left. So there is a carry generation again. So again, we will execute this statement. So this is the HL register pair. It will be added with DE register pair. HL register pair contains 0, 0, 0, A. And DE register pair contains what? This data only. So 0005. Now when we will add them, A plus 5 is equals to F, right? And zeros. So this will be the content in HL register pair, 000F. Now we will decrement the value of B. So it will be 00 hex. So now this is equals to 0. That means we will not jump to this location anymore. And we will store the result of HL register pair in some memory location. That means now we got our result. So as here we have done, the result is 0F hex, and here also we are getting 0F hex in L register. So we will store it here. So in C055 hex, we will store the lower significant bit, that is 0F. Okay. And in C056 hex, we will store the most significant bit, that is the H register, that is 00 hex. Okay, so in this way we have performed the shift and add process. And if you compare this instruction with all these steps, you will get to know that these steps are the reverse of these steps. So here this is the first step, then second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth, right? So how many steps we are getting zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means till the third step from the bottom side. And here also we can see, then till we have got 03 hex, we have got 00 in HL register pair. But in the second and the fourth step, that means when B is equals to 2 and 1, then we have added the HL register pair with DE register pair, as we have got carry here. So when a carry was generated, then we have added DE register pair with HL register pair, and thus we have got the result in these two steps. So this seems a bit clumsy, but I think this topic is clear now. And if you are still having any doubt, you can simply ask me in the comment section. And if you like this video, please subscribe the channel to get more videos on this topic. See you in the next video. Thank you.